Hello, baby. It's the Poltergeist 5000 back with more Ocarina of Time. In the last episode, we started on the adult half of the Spirit Temple, and we got our fancy-prancy mirror shield. We got the mirror shield! Ah! And my throat is, Now I gotta climb this wall. So basically what you wanna do here is just, when it reaches you, just start climbing. And just keep going. And then just keep going. And now this one goes faster, so you gotta go faster! Oh god, wait. Fuck! God damn it. Okay, hang on. Try that again. Because the top ones actually go a little bit faster than it's possible for you to move. So if you're not like, totally ready, and if you're between two of these things when they start moving, you'll actually take damage. So don't let that happen. All right, sneak by here. God, all the music in this area. It's like, I don't know how they came up with that kind of that melody line that's going like, just really cool. Anyway, I don't remember this room having all these slugs in it. This is weird. What's going on here? Oh god. Okay. But I believe this is where the boss key is, actually. Wait, is it? Or am I losing my gourd? I might be being dumby. No, that's definitely the boss key. Okay, so this is actually a little confusing. I want to throw a bomb at this one over here. And that reveals an eye switch. I really like, you know, I know I've mostly set my arrows and stuff to right C in this LP, but I really do like setting them to down C. I like having, like, you know, stuff that I shoot on one of the shoulder buttons, because it feels like, you know, you're pulling back on the bowstring, you're pulling. You're not just pushing a button, you're, like, pulling. It's like that little extra bit of force feedback that makes the control match the action, you know? I mean, you know that. Like, literally every FPS that you play on a controller does that. Ow. Except for, like, Metroid Prime, I guess. Nice. So here we are. This is pretty much the final stretch of the dungeon right here. When we actually get to start really using our mirror shield to do stuff. You can't hit that through there. That opens that door. Oh. You're supposed to hit that through there. Okay, I was gonna say, you can't hit this through here, but it doesn't, you're not supposed to, because it does this. I didn't even remember what it did. Wow. This is a weird room. This room is really weird, because there are these bubbles in here. Like, what's up with these things? A white bubble. Aim for it when it stops. Nice. Man, I cannot wait to keep recording Omori. The last recording session went very strangely, but ended on an extremely high note, followed by the lowest note in the entire series. So look forward to that in part, like, 40 fucking 9. Yeah, that is, that game is a lot of things, and short is not one of them. Oh, I really can't change that texture. I don't have the means. Bombs? Seriously? Bombs? Lamp oil rope? Bombs? You want it? It's yours, my friend, as long as you have enough rubies. The way he says you want it is so breathy. It's like, you want it? You know? Like, sounds strange. Get out of here. Would you stop that? Oh, you hurt me. Oh my god. Okay. Well, that shadow looks freaky. Okay, and that goes out to there. Oh, are we actually done the dungeon? Hang on a second. Hold on. I think we're actually done. Because we're gonna hop down here. And then we use this. Would you stop that? We use our mirror shield to shine light at that thing. And that causes this lift to drop down and fall back into this middle and drop into this middle room right in front of the goddess statue. And you'll never guess what you have to do here. I'm not sure how you're supposed to figure this out, but shine your light at it and the face crumbles. And oh my god, it's scary. I do not remember that looking that good. I remember that looking a lot more messy. And then you can hookshot it to it, and there's... Okay, that's the boss door. I was gonna say, like, wait a second. Okay, that's the boss door, thank goodness. And just like that, like, we're less than 5 minutes in, and we're already at the boss. I didn't... Man, this dungeon is short. This dungeon feels, like, so short because you do, like, half of it as an adult. You know, you do half of it because it's cut up so much.
Looks like someone is here, Kumi! Looks like it's Kotake! What an outrageous fellow he is to intrude so boldly into our temple! We should teach this outrageous fellow a lesson!
Man, going from the witches in Omori last night to these witches, it literally could not be a more stark contrast. but you're not gonna know what I'm talking about until like 2 months from now.
Oh, loyal minion! Destroy this intruder on our behalf!
Oh, no. It's an iron... What? Oh my god, that's fucking hilarious. That is like one of the funniest moments in this entire game. The mini boss like start the mini boss music starts playing. It's like starts playing and the mini boss is like, and then it realizes it doesn't have its axe and the mini boss and the boss music stops playing and then it just snaps its fingers and summons one. This is not an ordinary enemy. Oh no. Maybe I should use my max power. Ow. Why is there a... Oh, that's not a hookshot target. Whoa, I can't believe that worked. I was trying to roll past it. Woo! Man, you got a lot of health, motherfucker. Oh my gosh! No way. Wait, could it be... It's Naburu! What? Where am I? What is this?
Well, well, looks like she's back to normal, Kome. She's just a little girl, but she commands a lot of respect among the Gerudo Kotake. Maybe we should make her work for the great Ganondorf for a little while longer. Then we should brainwash her again!
Man, stop it, you... Oh my god! Jeez. Oh, they don't even care about me. They're just like, yeah, okay, whatever, some kid. Oh, jeez. Well. Yeah, so there you go. What? Oh, you know what? One thing that always bothered me about those two witches. Okay, their names are Kotake and Kume, right? Okay. Which one of those is ice and which one of those is fire, do you think? Because they have a fire and ice thing going on. Which one do you think is which? Which one do you think is which? Okay, go on. I'll give you like 5 seconds. Okay, did you guess that Kume was the ice one because Kume sounds cooler and Kotake was the fire one because Kotake has like a lot of sharp consonants and sounds spicy? Well, you're wrong, like me, because it's the other way around. Kume is the fire one and Kotake is the ice one, which is just, it's just so weird. Like, it just feels so weird. Anyway, here's the actual boss room. And guess what? You don't need your sword for the entire first half of this. You don't need your sword for the entire first half of this fight.
Look at that stupid kid. He came on his own to offer himself as a sacrifice to the great Ganondorf.
That's not what I did, you dumbass. Oh no.
Man, they're rattling teeth. With my flame, I will burn him to the bone!
Oh no.
With my frost, I will freeze him to his soul! I'm so happy.
Oh no. Sorcerer sisters, Twin Rova! Why are they called Twin Rova? I never understood that. Is that like a title given to like, because these two are basically like Ganondorf's nannies, I think. Yeah, Ganondorf's surrogate mother, Sorcerer Flame. She seems to be vulnerable to low temperature. I'm assuming that ice arrows and fire arrows don't work. Cause like, wait a second. Yeah. I'm assuming that they don't work because that would be too easy. But I'm gonna try, because if there's actually a reason to get ice arrows, besides a little bit of nope, they just dodge arrows. They just totally dodge arrows. What if I like no-scoped it? Maybe they wouldn't dodge it if I no-scoped it. Oh fuck, like move. Oh god! Wait! Don't jump! Don't just jump into that! Don't jump! Don't jump into the hard mix fire. Okay, so basically, yeah, these ladies shoot fire out. It's very scary, and they make like a big danger spot of very cool looking fire. And Kotake makes. Let's see how hers looks. Ah, not nearly as cool. So what you want to do here is you want to, and it actually helps to not be locked on here. Use the mirror shield to catch the stuff and then angle it into the other sister. And that's really all there is to it. I think once you hit them like four times, that we'll proceed into phase two. This is kind of a pain in the ass, but oh well. And nothing else works here. Like you saw me, I just tried to hit these fools with pretty much everything, every other thing I had, and it didn't work. So don't bother. Don't bother trying. Dude, hit her, man. Their hitboxes are like really small. Oh fuck! Ooh, that was close. Oh, I actually got her. I can't believe I actually got her. That's awesome. What I wonder if maybe you could hit them with stuff like with something like after you've hit. I really want to see if it's possible in any way to hit these bitches with arrows. Because if it was, then that would be really, really awesome. Okay, get your ice arrows ready. No, put them on that one. I want them on that one. Sir? Okay, that happened. Alright, switch over to the fire arrows. I don't think Din's fire would work either, but I don't know, maybe. Stop locking on. I want to angle myself, not look directly at her. I missed. Yeah, that's the most annoying thing about this, is just trying to move the camera around without locking onto them, because locking onto them is useless, you know? What the hell? I actually got her by doing that? Just by tapping on the Z-targeting? It happened to make my entire shit. So I swear to God, man. Oh, that's... Okay, no, that didn't do anything.
Okay, let's get serious now, Kotake. Okay, Kume. Kotake and Kumes, double dynamite attack!
What? Well, this is closer to those Amori babes, but not really my thing. A bit Gyaru, if you catch my drift. So this is Twin Rova's second form. This is the combined form of Kotake and Kume. Turn their magic attack back at them. So what she'll do is she'll shoot you with these magic attacks. But the thing is, she literally always does them. Three fire, three ice. And that's what you need. You need to catch three of the same kind of magic in a row. And then aim it at her. And then bada bing, bada boo. Oh man, look how cool the mirror shield looks. And then you can go at her with your sword.
Uh-huh.
And then that's it. Like, that's the whole, like, that's all there is to it. And as long as you never mess this up, I believe, like, if you miss one, then it can get more complicated because then it'll mess up her pattern. But as long as you do this perfectly, whoa, okay, never mind. Make a liar out of me. I remember on like my first few playthroughs, she consistently, you know, was consistent. She would always do three fire, three ice, you know, no fancy do's, no trickery biz. She would always do it. It was very strange. And she's dead. That is one boss fight I do not feel bad at all about cheesing with the big Auron sword and killing really, really fast, because it's kind of a boring pain in the ass. And there's really nothing else you can do there. Like, there's no cool methods you can use. It's just gotta do it.
Shoot! What a fresh kid! This time we'll get serious! Fight, Kotake! What? Hey, Kume, what is that above your head?
What is that above your head? Why are you going to heaven? Where the hell do you think you're going?
I don't know, but you have one over your head too, Kotake!
Oh, no!
But I'm only 400 years old! And I'm just 380! What twins are gonna have a rage? You must have gotten senile! Who are you kind of senile? Are you your older sister? We are twins! How can you be older? Yeah! How heartless you are! How can you be so ungrateful? You're heartless! Oh, you're ungrateful! Oh, my goodness! I'll come back to haunt you!
Good lord. What a ridiculous... Like, you can't... Well, there's the last heart container. Da-da-da. It's just ridiculous how, like, this is the last dungeon before Ganon, and they inject so much humor into the boss fights. You know, first you have that hilarious moment before you fight Nibiru in the Iron Knuckle armor, where she tries to act intimidating, but then she realizes she doesn't have her axe, and they let the air out of the band. And then, you know, Twin Rova winks at you, and then those two get to bicker like the twinsies that they are, as they get carried off to heaven in a ray of light. It's like, what the hell is going on in this game? Like, make up your mind. Well, like, you know, pick a tone, you know? That would be a really weird scene if this game ever got remade, like that, you know, that Final Fantasy VII style remake that I keep talking about. That, like, I don't know, how would they adapt that scene? Would they just ditch the comedic elements? Because that would really suck, but at the same time, it's kind of inappropriate timing. You know, I guess not really. You know, it's just, you know, you might think, oh, it's inappropriate timing, but that's just what life is. It doesn't always have appropriate timing. Kid, let me thank you. Look at the little kid has become in the past 7 years. A competent swordsman. Hey, I was competent before. By the way, I really messed up. I was brainwashed by those old witches and used by Ganondorf to do his evil will. What happened to you after they hit you with that spell before the boss fight? But isn't it funny that a person like me can turn out to be the Sage of Spirit? And now I'm gonna fight them as one of the six sages. I'm gonna pay them back for what they did to me. Kid. No, P5000, the hero of time! Instead of keeping the promise I made back then, I give you this medallion. Take it. I shall. Aren't you the hero of time?
Yep.
And this is your ID.
Yep.
I found this ID in this wallet. And if that's the case, then this must be your wallet.
That makes sense to me.
Then take it.
Oh, man. If only I knew you would become such a handsome man.
Yeah, you pour on the ship tees. You know, those echoes of the dating sim element of beta. I should have kept the promise I made back then.
What?
What you talking about?
Oh, what you talking about? Oh, geez, we got another cutscene here. Oh, God.
P5000, the hero! Finally, all of us, the six sages, have been awakened. The time for the final showdown with the King of Evil has come! Before that, though, you should meet the one who is waiting for you. The one who is waiting for you at the Temple of Time.
Yeah, I'm working on it.
Oh, that's all?
I thought that was gonna shunt me right into that cutscene. Well, there's really no better way to do this than to just teleport over there, so I guess we have to go do that right now. I'm gonna do that right now because I actually have a plan for the next episode. That decidedly does not involve anything story relevant. So, yeah. I've been waiting for a UP5000. What? Oh, I wish I'd had the... Man! Good lord! Zoom right out of our ass. Or their ass, or whatever. PR1000, the hero of time. You have overcome many hardships and awakened six sages. Yes, I sure enough have. Man, nice thumbnail. Well, I want to get Twin Rova in the thumbnail. And now you have a final challenge, a showdown with Ganondorf, the King of Evil. Before that, I have things I want to tell only to you. Please listen. Another unknown legend of the Triforce passed down by the Shadowfolk, the Sheikahs. Oh my god, I should have waited until the next episode to do this. Holy crap, this is gonna... We got an entire fucking goddess cutscene here. If you would seek the sacred triangle, listen well. You can't put the word triangle in your mythology. That sounds so stupid. The resting place of the sacred triangle, the sacred realm, is a mirror that reflects what is in the heart. The heart of one who enters it. If an evil heart, the realm will become full of evil. If pure, the realm will become a paradise. The Triforce, the sacred triangle. It is a balance that weighs the three forces: power, wisdom, and courage. Jeez. If the heart of the one who holds the sacred triangle, would you stop saying that, has all three forces in balance, that one will gain the true force to govern all. Wow, okay. That's all it takes? But if that one's heart is not in balance, the Triforce will separate into three parts: power, wisdom, and courage. Only one part will remain for the one who touched the Triforce, the part representing the force that one most believes in. If that one seeks the true force, that one must acquire the two lost parts. That one, to turn into that bunny, those two parts will be held within others chosen by destiny, who will bear the Triforce mark on the backs of their hands. I'm surprised that hasn't come up yet, yeah. Seven years ago, Ganondorf, the King of Thieves, used the door you opened in the Temple of Time and entered the Sacred Realm. See, that confuses me. Like, how do I get to the Sacred Realm from there? How does anybody actually get to the Sacred Realm from that room? It's just a room. But when he laid his hands on the Triforce, the legend came true. The Triforce separated into three parts. Only the Triforce of Power remained in Ganondorf's hand. The strength of the Triforce of Power enabled him to become a mighty evil king, but his dark ambitions were not satisfied. Yeah. To gain complete mastery of the world, Ganondorf started looking for those chosen by destiny to hold the two other Triforce parts. The one who holds the Triforce of Courage is you, P5000! No reaction. And the other, who holds the Triforce of Wisdom, is the seventh sage, who is destined to be the leader of them all. Oh my god! Say goodbye to Sheik, and welcome back to the world's slowest pen. And that rivals the slow pen on those witches in Omori the other day. It is I, the Princess of Hyrule, Zelda. Yeah, sure enough. Look at that box-shaped. I've heard of barrel-chested, but never box-chested. I apologize for meeting you in disguise, but it was necessary to hide from the King of Evil. Please forgive me. Not anymore, though, now, I guess, for some reason. On that day, 7 years ago, Ganondorf attacked Hyrule Castle. Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, I was there, in the water. I saw you as I was escaping from the castle with my attendant, Impa. Why is it in grayscale? none of the flashbacks have been in grayscale thus far. I thought I should entrust the Ocarina to you. I thought that would be our best chance. Well, for better or for worse, I think we're pretty much ready to stop Ganondorf now. As long as you have the Ocarina in your position, I thought Ganondorf could never enter the Sacred Realm, but something I could never expect happened. The Master Sword had an age rating and froze you in time. Like, who could have seen that coming? After you opened the door, the Master Sword sealed you away in the Sacred Realm. Your spirit remained in the Sacred Realm, and then the Triforce fell into Ganondorf's hands. He went on to invade the Sacred Realm. Well, I thought he went to the Sacred Realm to get the Triforce. Ganondorf had become the evil king, and the Sacred Realm became a world of evil. All this is an unfortunate coincidence. I passed myself off as a Sheikah and hoped that you would return. I waited for 7 years. Yay, so happy. And now you're back. The Dark Age ruled by Ganondorf, the evil king, will end. With my high layer eyebrows. Yay, so happy. The six sages will open the sealed door and lure Ganondorf back into the Sacred Realm. I will then seal the door to the Sacred Realm from this world. Thus, Ganondorf the Evil King will vanish from Hyrule. P5000, in order to do this, I need your courage again. Please protect me while I do my part. And here is a weapon that can penetrate the Evil King's defenses. The power given to the Chosen Ones. The Sacred Arrow of Light! Ha! Man. Jeez.
Ooh, it's pretty.
Man, what a funny angle. You got the light arrow! Set it to see and your arrows will be powered up. The light of justice will smite evil. Yes, victorious. Gohiro. What? 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 What?
That rumbling, it can't be. Toadsworth, did you see? Huh?
Oh, God! No! Princess Zelda, you foolish traitor. I commend you for avoiding my pursuit for 7 long years. But you let your guard down. I knew you would appear if I let this kid wander around. He's just been letting us wander around. Oh my God, that's scary. You know, it's like I kidnapped the princess while you were running around. My only mistake was to slightly underestimate the power of this kid. Yeah, I got every heart piece. What are you gonna do, Ganondorf? God, that's scary. No, it was not the kid's power I misjudged. It was the power of the Triforce of Courage. Yeah, you know what? In retrospect, the heart containers haven't helped me much. I've almost died multiple times even though I had all these heart containers. But with the reference of wisdom that Zelda has, when I obtain these 2 Triforces, then... I will become the true ruler of the world! If you want to rescue Zelda, come to my castle! Yeah, I'll work on that.
Man!
Well, I guess we better do that. But we're gonna do that... next time on Ocarina of Time. We will... go to Ganon's castle. Is there a more credity place where I could end this episode? Maybe like outside Ganon's castle. No, if I go over to Ganon's castle, there's gonna be another cutscene. Yeah, I'm just gonna stop here. And next time on Ocarina of Time, we will head for Ganon's castle. I am actually gonna dip in there a little bit, like right away. Because there's actually an upgrade that you can get about when you're about a tenth of the way into that place that you would normally have have no use for. So I'm going to get it right away and then go do the last of my faffing. So, bye, and I'll see you next time.